we want to simplify the given radicals that contain fractions. So for the square root of 4/9, we can rewrite this as the square root of the numerator over the square root of the denominator. And since both 4 and 9 are perfect squares, this will simplify perfectly. To show this, we could rewrite the square root of 4 as the square root of 2 times 2, and we could write the square root of 9 as the square root of 3 times 3. This just helps show that 4 is a perfect square because it's equal to 2 times 2, and 9 is a perfect square because it's equal to 3 times 3. Therefore, the square root of 4 is equal to 2, and the square root of 9 is equal to 3, so this simplifies to 2/3. Next we have negative 2 times the square root of 1 over 121. So we'll write negative 2 as negative 2 over 1 times, and this is going to be equal to the square root of 1 over the square root of 121. And again, because 1 and 121 are perfect squares, this will simplify perfectly. To show this, we could rewrite this as the square root of 1 times 1, and then 121 is equal to 11 times 11. This step isn't necessary, but again, it does emphasize that these are both perfect squares, and therefore will simplify perfectly. We would have negative 2 over 1 times the square root of 1 is 1, and the square root of 121 is equal to 11. So negative 2 over 1 times 1 over 11 is equal to negative 2/11. Our last example is a cube root, but the steps will be the same. This is equal to the cube root of 27 over the cube root of 125. And again, because 27 and 125 are perfect cubes, this will simplify perfectly. Again, to show this, we could rewrite the cube root of 27 as the cube root of 3 times 3 times 3, and the cube root of 125 as the cube root of 5 times 5 times 5. And again, because we have 3 equal factors, this is the perfect cube, and so is this. So the cube root of 27 is equal to 1 factor of 3, and the cube root of 125 is equal to 1 factor of 5. So this simplifies nicely to 3/5.